Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon, Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Komkon, Adonai. I will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham.
Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says, and we want to welcome you back and being so faithful and joining us every Friday evening at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn more about what Jesus has to say on controversial issues facing us today. If you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, we thank you for another segment and an opportunity to win souls for the kingdom. You get all honor and glory that you're worthy and you do, Lord God. We pray for those that are less fortunate, those in hospitals, nursing homes, hospices, homeless shelters, those incarcerated, unemployed, those on death row, that you give them peace. We pray for your apostles, prophets, evangelists, preachers, teachers, local and universal. We pray for your churches, local and universal. We pray for our leadership all over the world. We pray for our enemies that they cease from troubling. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem, that we prosper, that love the holy city. Peace be in our gates, prosperity in our palaces. Pray for the salvation of Israel, that they come to know you as their God, Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Pray for our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and marines, and all our civil servants that stand watch over our safety. Now we lift this broadcast up to you, Lord God, that you take charge, order our steps, and lead our conversation. In Jesus' name, amen. The sacrifice is what we're talking about tonight. And we're going to have a great discussion, and we're looking forward to have you chime in. So if you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. Amen.
Hey, you've reached Michael. If you leave me a message, I will call you back.
Amen. Who do we have on the line?
At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Okay, who do we have on the line? Anybody? Let's see who we have on the line.
Hello? Hello?
Who do we have on the line?
Is it?
Okay, you ready to go? Let's see who else do we
have. Yeah, I guess so.
Okay, let's see who else do we have. Okay. Tonight, we're talking about the sacrifice, and we can go ahead and give you the scriptures so when you get a chance, you can look them up. The scripture readings tonight are coming from Genesis 21:33 and Luke 2:41. Let's get that other call. Who else do we have on the line? Okay, let me see if I can get this person on the line we've been trying to call. And we'll get started. So how was your week?
Fine.
Okay. We're going to go to a break, and then hopefully she's not sleeping. And we'll get right back.
All right.
Hello?
Who do we have on the line?
Anna Mitchum.
Do you know what we do every Friday at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time?
Very aware of that.
We very aware of that. Are you very aware of that? I don't have much time. So,
no, she's coming.
What now?
She's coming.
Look, why did she answer the phone?
Because she's in the bathroom.
Oh, okay. I guess that's too graphic. You should have said that's personal business.
Well, whatever.
But
Let me help her. Okay.
Okay. I'm going ahead and get started. Okay. Tonight we're going to talk about the sacrifice. Now, look, God is given us in Genesis a foreshadowing of things to come. Now, foreshadowing is simply a preview or a trailer or a commercial or some kind of a, you know, when you go to the movies, they give you this trailer, a preview of what the movie is going to be. Are you familiar with that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
So that's what it is when we're reading Genesis. So we're going to read Genesis 22. And we're going to go ahead and read the whole thing. Genesis 22:1. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham. And he said, Behold, here I am. And he said, Take thou now thy son, thine only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. Okay. And Aaron, Abraham, rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass and took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and clave the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went to the place of which God had told him. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar. And when Abraham saw unto his son, his young men, he said unto his young men, Abide here with the ass, and I and the lad will yonder and worship and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood and the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac, his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham, his father, and said, My father. And he said, Here am I, my son. And he said, Behold, the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? And Abraham, pay close attention to this, and Abraham said, My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went, and both of them together. And they came to the place which God had told him of. And Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac, his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. Here am I. And he said, Lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thine only son from me. And ate up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by the horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering instead of his son. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh. And it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. Amen. Now look.
Yeah.
That's some serious obedience. He didn't stagger. He staggered not at the promises of God, and he did exactly what he told him to do when he told him to do it. Now let's go to the New Testament, and we're going to Luke 2. And we're going to go to the 41st verse. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. And when they had fulfilled the days, as they returned, the child Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem. And Joseph and his mother knew not of it. But they, supposing him to have been in the company, went a day's journey And they sought him among their kinfolk and acquaintance. And when they found him not, they turned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him. And it came to pass that after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, and behold, both hearing them and asking them questions. And all that heard him were astonished at his understanding and answers. And when they saw him, they were amazed. And his mother said unto him, Son, why hast thou thus dealt with us? Behold, thy father and I have sought thee sorrowing. And he said unto them, How is it that ye sought me? Wist thee not that I must be about my father's business? And they understood not the saying which he spake unto them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was subject unto them. But his mother kept all these sayings in her heart. Now, there is a lady named Annie Mae Mitchum. They said this rhyme. They said, there once is an old lady that lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. Now, if she told the truth, she'll tell you about the time she left her children in the gas station, left her babies all on the sidewalk waiting to come home from school, and she forgot to pick them up and had to go pick them up at 9 o'clock at night. The baby's still on the sidewalk. And so these are crazy times. Now, you would imagine, now the child been sitting there from the time she got out of school to 9 o'clock at night. Now, do you think that would happen today?
Nope. I mean,
could you do that today?
No, you couldn't do that today.
Now, why did you leave your children behind? You didn't know they were with you? You can come up with any old kind of excuse. But that's sort of strange, though, because I'm going to give you a break. You at least had a car. Now, you know who's in the car. But Jesus, how you going to not know your child for a whole day and you're walking? That's sort of strange, isn't it?
Yeah, that is strange.
It ain't like y'all in an airplane or a car. Or, you know, it ain't like it was fast. It's like you turn around and you say, where is Jesus? But they went a whole day and didn't know he was with them. Otherwise, they would have had a big entourage and a lot of people with them. I don't know how that happened. I'm going to have to ask God about that. You ever thought about that? How you going to go a whole day without knowing you with your child? No, that ain't going to work. So, but this thing about 3 days, though, he stayed there for 3 days. And, you know, it doesn't tell you who took care of him or anything, does it? It didn't say nothing how he ate or nothing, how he got something to eat. But he was there in that temple for 3 days in his father's house. Now, watch this. Now, when Abraham came to the place, he saw 3 days ahead. He saw where he had to take Isaac to sacrifice him, right? He made the Hall of Fame of Faith in Hebrews, the first chapter, 11th chapter, starting off telling you about faith. And he said he reasoned in himself if he had sacrificed his son that God would raise him from the dead. Now, he had never seen anybody raised from the dead. How could he have thought? He said, well, God gave him to me, so obviously if I killed him, he going to bring him back because his promise was that he was going to make my seed great. So, okay. So what kind of faith would it take to make a sacrifice like that? He didn't even question God. He just saddled his ass up, put him on the altar and get ready. Okay, God himself. Now watch this. This is the foreshadowing. He said God himself will provide the sacrifice. Now, Jesus is God. And when they took him to the Passover, what do you think they were doing?
Oh, man.
They were preparing the Lamb of God for the sacrifice. They took the Lamb. Jesus is the Lamb, isn't he?
Yeah.
Isn't that what they did every year? They went to the Passover. But needless to say, the Passover was not the same Passover that they had come to know, but their son was going to actually be the sacrifice. God himself would be the sacrifice. Do you understand that?
God himself.
God himself be the sacrifice. So when we talk about behold the lamb, that's exactly what we're talking about. So let's listen to that and just ponder on that thought for a minute.
Thank you. shed your blood for me, Jesus, on Calvary. Thank you for being born for me, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For loving me so.
Never, never, never know.
For loving me so. Yeah.
Thank you for your blood. Yeah.
I thought it'd be fitting for us to get in the mood for, that's why we celebrate the coming of the Lamb of God. Amen.
Yeah.
A lot of people look at it as a time for gifts, but the greatest gift of all is the Lamb of God that was shed for the remission of our sin. He came that we might have life and life more abundantly. You understand? So for those about there that are not saved, he says in Romans 10:9, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, that you're saved. Because with the mouth, confession is made to salvation. And with the heart, belief is made into righteousness. And we believe that. And in Luke 11:13, he says, you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. How much more will your heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit if you ask? The Holy Ghost. Now look, that's the good gift. The gift of this year that keeps giving. The gift of the Holy Spirit is Jesus. Fullness of God here in Colossians 2:9, right? See, that's a misrepresentation in the church that they got through the doctrines of man. They call it the Trinity, but that's not in the word. That came through Catholicism. The true meaning of who God is the fullness of the Godhead. And the fullness of the Godhead are three persons in one, and that's Jesus the Father, Jesus the Son, and Jesus the Holy Ghost. They're all three the same. Just like Annie Mae is my mother. She was Ella's daughter. And she was Wisba's wife, but she's still the same person. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
So you three people in one. You three things in one, aren't you?
Yes, yes.
But are you split up or are you the same person?
I'm the same person.
Same person, just one.
And so,
when you see the Father, you've seen the Son. So when you see Jesus, you've seen the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Does that make sense to you? Just read Isaiah 9:6. So when we see someone on task, and Jesus was on task, he didn't have time to play. He's very serious about what he did. You don't deter them from their goal or their mission in life. He said, now look, you knew the deal before I even came down there. Why would you think I was worrying you and I'd be about my Father's business? And they didn't understand, but Mary kept all of this in the back of her head so that just like Gabriel told her, he said, this is going to pierce your heart that you don't have to lose your son in only 33 years. God gave you a blessing and you'll be blessed women, but in 33 years, it's a wrap. And it's going to tear you asunder to your heart, be pierced like a sword going towards your heart. And so she pondered all this that should take place. So when you are married to someone with purpose, it doesn't mean that you're going to have a long life. It's going to have a fulfilled life, knowing that he gets glory. Like Martin Luther King was only 39 years old. But look how great honor the Lord placed upon him. They got people, dignitaries know who Martin Luther King is all over the world. Celebrations, right? Okay. So that's what we're talking about tonight, is that when you're on task, you got to make a sacrifice. He sacrificed his life, not just his physical life, but his life for his ministry. He was the shepherd that said, I will comfort you. The rod and my staff, I will comfort you like a shepherd. You're my shepherd, Lord. That's what that scripture is about. Lord, you're my shepherd. I shall not want. You make me to lie down in green pastures. You lead me beside the still waters. You restore my soul. You lead me in the paths of righteousness. For your name, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I feel no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, you comfort me. You prepare people before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, cup running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord. And he's telling you he'll prepare a table so you can just relax and chill, knowing that his rod and his staff, he comforts you. Even in the presence of your enemy to the death, you go through the valley of the shadow of death, you feel no evil because he with you. That's like he said in Psalm 27, that your enemies came to eat upon your flesh, but they stumble and fail. You got to be about your mission. Are you about your mission in life? Are you that focused that nothing deters you from your mission? What's your mission in life?
My mission is pay God, save God.
Amen. That's a good mission. It might be simplistic, but that's what he is. He said he inhabits the praises of his people. And he said you learn to perfect praise through the mouths of babes. So he's all about praise and worship. You understand? Who else got a mission statement? Anybody else got a mission?
Speak up in there. Speak up, yes. I can't hear you, but
what?
Do you have a mission?
Dog barking.
Amen.
You got a mission? Amen.
Okay, so who's going to sum up what we talked about tonight?
Well, I'm going to sum up what we talked about God himself. It is the sacrifice.
Amen.
And since God himself is the sacrifice, he's going to always be there for us.
Amen.
And so that's the whole idea.
Amen. Go ahead and pray for it then.
Dear Lord, our God, our Heavenly Father, we are glad, we are honored, we are proud that you are our mission, you are our sacrifice.
Yes, Jesus.
Help us to obey you, Lord, and serve you to the best of our ability. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. So let Sheriff Caesar take us out.
Teach me, Master. Master, teach me. Oh, teach me how to wait.
Oh,
when I abide at the altar, oh, teach me what to say. Oh, I would not live a liar. I'll tell you the reason why I'm afraid. My Lord might call me. Oh, yeah. And teach
oh,
me.
Yeah.
Come on, Master.
Teach me, Master.
Uh-huh.
Teach me.
You know that sound good right now. Listen.
Teach me,
uh-huh.
Master. Teach
oh, yeah.
Me.
Oh, teach
me how
to pray. When
oh,
I
yeah.
For I would not be a gambler.
Oh,
yeah. At the altar,
oh,
yeah.
Altar.
Oh.
Thank you guys for joining. Looking forward to having you again for another edition of What Jesus Said. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.